Jambo pande.
Jambo jambo.
I'm number 73010 PPC Ocean Peterson.
Yes.
Afanda, I'm requesting you to give me the clarity on the difference between
yes
anti-corruption unit and the professional standard unit and the way they work.
Okay. This I can, the others will add, but the State House Anti-Corruption Unit is a rapid response unit that was launched by His Excellency the President. We are directly under the supervision of His Excellency the President. We coordinate with all mandated agencies, but the first one we coordinate with is Uganda Police Forces. And so all the cases of that are reported to the Anti-Corruption Unit of State House are investigated by detective police officers. Police Standards Unit handles cases of indiscipline or administrative nature. So when those cases come, so the Police Standards Unit handles the professionalism, the discipline of Uganda police. I don't know whether Police Standards Unit can also handle civilians, does it? That I don't know. So it is only for police, but for us, we are wide. We work with all agencies. The IGP gives us authority to also investigate the police officers who are involved in corruption tendencies. And I said that we have 39 police officers arraigned before courts of law, investigated by their colleague police detectives. Don't be part of those that are in court. You come to add value. So Police Standards Unit is for the discipline of police and the management of the indiscipline. Go ahead.
Jambo Fande.
Jambo Jambo.
Number 74368 PPC Okengo Rockford. Afande, my question is there any protection for the witnesses of the corruption cases to avoid interruption with allegation?
It is the duty of police to ensure that those who report are protected. Again, you are the one supposed to protect all civilians. So there isn't a clear law yet. Currently, there is no past law of whistleblower protection, but it is our duty, us that are involved in investigating the crimes, and in particular police detectives, to ensure that whistleblowers are not harmed by criminals or the corrupt. So you have to use your professionalism to ensure that whistleblowers are protected. Don't expose them. At Anti-Corruption Unit, we ensure that our informers, our whistleblowers, are not exposed, and we have not had any bad incident where a whistleblower has been badly victimized. So there is no law, but it is our duty, me and you, in uniform, supposed to protect the people and their properties.
Most cases I see, it beats my understanding. When they are investigating an allegation, there is no equal punishment for the crime that a person has committed. Like someone has stolen over 300 million, but in most cases is granted a bail within a short time of 2 weeks. So in these cases, police are blamed majorly for such laws. It was my request now, if through your office, that some of the laws have to be amended such that these criminals are handled properly, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, my comrade. My office is too small to influence the law changing. That is in the hands of the legislators, that is Parliament. But I think that the process maybe is starting or about to start, but my office cannot do that, my comrade. But clearly, once a case is well investigated, it is the responsibility of police officers to ensure that people the criminals are arraigned to courts of law in the stipulated period of time, and they have built a good file to prosecute. You see, police remains the gatekeeper. So it depends upon the duration of the investigations, and also the evidence you will have put on your file. I am, and when you say that people are given bail, again, that is a matter that is decided by the honorable independent courts. But for you police officers, if you want to guard, you are the gatekeepers, decide to investigate your file and have every evidence, so when the courts don't do their work, us in security will not be blamed. The blame will be on those that are giving endless bail, but when you present the needed evidence, I believe that it will be hard for the judicial officers to just joke with the files. But the courts are independent. We cannot order them to do what they must do. Again, the issue of changing, my office cannot influence that.
Jambo, Afande.
Jambo, Jambo.
I'm number 7, double 467, PPC, Opio, Nyatpaji, Peter.
Peter Nyachipedi. Yes.
Sir, you find that if you want to protect something, you don't come from the head, you come from the grassroots.
Yes.
So, as you, the unit of anti-corruption, do you always go to those public or civilian to say, start them about anti-corruption? Because we, the police officer, they are the one practicing this. But now, as you always first time the public, because they are not aware of anything. Secondly, you find that due with the investigation in the course of investigating crime about and corruption, you find that the officials always faces challenges in the due of and corruption. Now, how do you overcome these challenges in order for the official to be effective? Thank you.
Which challenges, first of all?
Like you find that there's the adulteration of file, some file after filing can come and pick. You find that the suspect is being about to go away, like to be away from the safe custody that can make the delay or the court not to be there. Thank you.
It is police that is responsible for gathering evidence, keeping it in safe custody, and presenting it to court. So, Peter, determine that you're going to protect your file, you're going to have to collect evidence professionally, arrange your file properly, and take it to court. About sensitizing, we do it whenever we are given opportunity, we sensitize the public, not to be corrupt. Also not to corrupt our officers. But you officers, you the police personnel, choose never to be compromised, and nobody will. Again, your uniform has a lot of authority. So use it to show that the state is not to joke with. The state has all the power. Your uniform represents the state. The state has the power to protect, power to empower the people that are worth empowering. So please, be good agents of good hope. And not just hope, but action.
Jambo, Vande.
Jambo, Jambo.
Number 7, you read 114, PPC Omoyo Peter.
Omoyo Peter.
Afande, to be specific, we are too delighted for your lecture.
Thank you.
And probably as you move out, send the greetings to the Muzei.
Yes. Peter is sending me to greet his commander-in-chief while we're laughing, and I'll take the greetings for all of you.
Yes,
I will say the 5,000 vigilant police personnel are waiting for you with excitement to send them out to cause great change.
Yes, sir.
Will you make it happen?
Yes, sir.
All right. Yes, Peter, go ahead.
On his commission of anti-corruption, besides that, we see the IGG office, that is the in the investigation general of government.
Inspector general of government. Yes.
Then now here comes. I wanted to know which interpol relationship is there between police and corruption unit and IGG, and if it is there, where does anti-corruption unit pick up from? Because if it is police, if there's any crime, I infect the arrest, I investigate. Where and how does anti-corruption unit come in to pick in? If there's probably understand there might be a Kwasi or a tribunal court within your unit. So where do you go to pick up from police, and from there, where do you end?
Peter, thank you very much for you needed that clarity. I clearly said, and Peter, listen to me because you have asked. Because when you start going, you may not hear properly. All cases that are reported to the State House and Corruption Unit are investigated by detective police officers who are attached to the State House and Corruption Unit. And all when they investigate the files conclusively in the timelines that we set ourselves, they take their files to the DPP. It is the DPP that takes the files to court. In other words, all the cases of anti-corruption unit are investigated by police detectives, and the prosecutor is the DPP. Office of DPP prosecutes, or the DPP herself, and the courts are independent. Have you gotten how we work? The relationship between IGG and anti-corruption and state and police. Clearly, anti-corruption unit of police is for the commanding chief of the armed forces and His Excellency the President. So all agencies work with us closely, but the IG, Inspectorate of Government, is independent, and it is the institution that heads the anti-corruption fight. So some cases of ombudsman, like administrative, some big cases, what we do at anti-corruption unit, we refer them to the Inspectorate of Government. So you get the relationship. We work with police as anti-corruption unit to investigate the cases, to cause arrests, to forward the files to DPP. DPP prosecutes. Courts are independent. Once we reach the cases are in the courts, we withdraw our hand. IGG, Inspectorate of Government, or Inspector General of Government, they are independent. They have some police officers, but for them, as the inspectorate, they prosecute their cases. They have the power to prosecute, which anti-corruption doesn't have. You understand now? Very good.
Jambo, Fande.
Jambo, jambo.
I'm number 73598, Dabo Popachali, Sekaji Julius.
Sekaji Julius.
Yes, Afande. Afande, throughout your lecture, you've been emphasizing that all, in order to curb the vice of corruption in the country, all duties lie on the side of the police officer.
Yes.
And now,
crime,
before corruption in the entire public is fought, it is the duty of the police officer. The police officer.
Yes.
Now my question comes: before we fight corruption, what brings it? In fact, like before you fight corona in the country, you find what causes corona and what are those standard operating procedures before you treat it. It's just like any other disease.
I get your question. I want us to be heard. You are saying the causes of corruption. Corruption is a moral issue. It is in your head. No, corruption is a moral and spiritual issue. Corruption is not infectious. No, it is a moral issue. It is spiritual. You must choose not to be corrupt. Otherwise, once you are compromised, once you allow yourself to be compromised, then you will be prosecuted. You'll be taken to court. So the causes of corruption are, it is immoral. The moral fiber is gone. So that's why we, in our appeal to the public, we are saying, let the teacher, the parents be the first ones to stop corruption, because charity begins at home. The home you are brought up in is where your morals start from. Once your parents don't show you that corruption is terrible, they give you money to go and bribe for to become a monitor in class. So then they have transferred corruption from home to school, from school to high institutions of learning, from institutions back to the community. Corruption is a moral issue. That is the cause. So you choose never to be corrupt and never to allow your neighbor, your parent, your teacher to corrupt you or to be corrupt. So corruption is a moral issue. It is not picked anywhere. It is not being spread by, it is in the heads of people, and we have to fight it by sensitizing about its effects. What we need to teach about is the terrible effects of corruption, which include death. Because corruption is what is what causes all crimes that finally lead to death. But importantly, corruption has derailed the national development of our country, and police has the power to stop it. Because when you arrest a Nemachem working with the media, and I want to thank our media colleagues, because when they help us to name and shame the corrupt, once people, nobody wants to be exposed as a corrupt person. Yet when they are stealing, they think they are enriching themselves and going to be better. But once they are exposed to the public, then their image goes down completely. So corruption causes morals.
My second question and the very last one, ever since the anti-corruption unit was formed, what are some of its core achievements in the country?
I thought
its
I was
very
summarizing
core achievements.
Core achievements. Number one, we have is public trust. We are trusted in the public because all cases that we investigate, they all go to court, meaning that the detective police officers are good, that are attached to anti-corruption are doing good work. Number two, we have recovered close to 30 billion shillings for government. Number three, we have taken the implicated the corrupt officials of or those that were in offices of government, close to 200, total 317 persons, and those that are in courts of law, the public officials who are over 200, they are all on interdiction. They are no longer in government offices. We have 40 persons already convicted and are serving different prison sentences. Those who will never serve government for the next 10 years. Are those simple achievements?
No.
We have many achievements. So, but those are the key ones. Go ahead.
Jambo, Vane.
Jambo, jambo.
Number 74555 BBC Ugandan Rights TV. Pande, as we are going to be in a system, I've seen, I wanted to ask this, that what are the great challenges that the institution as anti-corruption body has faced, as we are also going to help the institution in the fight against corruption too.
You're saying how?
What are the challenges that the institution
challenges in the fight against corruption? I'll tell you a few. The second is what? Let's be quick. We are getting late. It's about to rain and we have to go and work. No time wasting, remember.
Yes.
Allow me remind you the four principles that you must keep and write them, please. Number one, always be obedient if you want to be an effective officer. Be obedient. Always be ready for action. Readiness is very key.
Afande, suppose I'm investigating officer on a certain crime. Then, when we go to courts of law, the complainant wins that offense. Offset it was of theft. Then, the complainant wins. In accordance to appreciate me, what I've done for her, to investigate, she brings me 500 shillings. Am I supposed to receive that money? If she gives it me, if she gives it out in a good faith, am I supposed to receive that money? Oh, that's corruption.
It is corruption because the one we have said, if you have done your work, government is paying you for that. Why should someone add you the money that you have done well the case has, but now I'm giving you the money? If I understand this, me working with you in police, I mean in security forces, if I choose to appreciate you for the work that we are doing, I am in my line of duty. I'm only motivating you from maybe my own assessment to say this officer needs motivation and appreciation. But let not an outsider, you are supposed, I mean, let not the community, the citizens who you are supposed to serve be the ones to pay you for your work. You understand the difference? Let your leaders be the ones to appreciate you, not the people you are supposed to serve. Because how are you going to differentiate a bribe and what they are calling gratification? That is a bribe. Don't be appreciated by those that didn't send you for duty. They are not the ones that sent you. You represent the state, and the state will pay you. Let your leaders be the ones to appreciate you. And if you refuse those offers, that's how you're going to earn your name. No one can come looking for Nakaima to give you anything. I'll not accept. I'll tell you, please, I am very well paid and catered for by the state. What are you looking for? I'm here to serve you, and the state is appreciating, and the state appreciates better because they'll give you, your career will develop high, you will be promoted, you will have your moral authority to go anywhere and speak without fear or favor. Don't you like that? Yeah, don't be in the community and someone is looking at you with an eye, this one I already gave something. No, I hate it myself, and please hate it. Don't be compromised. Finally,
I'm number 7307056. Madam, many questions have been asked inside the offices, but mine is outside.
Yes.
Mostly on traffic officers. You find when taxis are traveling mostly, you find them, they're supposed to carry 14 passengers in a taxi. But you find them carrying more than 14. But when you're moving, you find a police officer stops the vehicle, as you say. But instead of telling the driver that police carry only 14 passengers, park those excess ones aside, another vehicle check, they also accept what the drivers or the conductors give them. How can we overcome that?
Again, my sister, that is a moral issue. Why should you, the police officer, given a symbol of authority, a uniform of traffic that can stop all thousands of vehicles just in your hand? Then someone is giving you whatever it is and you are receiving and putting in your pocket. God forbid you can't cause a change. Stop that tax and pull all the people down, put all the doors that are allowed and let it go. Then no driver will again start looking at the police with an eye. I'm over why I'm 12 akuleke. God forbid. Come on, be change agents. When you are in traffic, my sister, be the first one to stop that taxi with it, which will have overloaded. Put all the passengers out and order the conductor to put the fuel. Even they're supposed to be hot. We are still in COVID.
Yes.
Please come and use your authority very well. Use it because send not just fear, but send instructions that there is no jokes. No jokes.
Yes, sir. And I found it. Now I'm the junior traffic officer, and my superiors are there, and I try to implement what I've learned from here. And they become harsh and hard on me. How will I overcome that?
Report them to us. We are here. We are here. You report the ones and say we are trying to do good, but our bosses are a problem. I can assure you there will be changes that day. We have caused some changes somewhere. Okay?
Kazi, 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 Kaz